the public school system in the U.S., the music programs have basically gone away. And there's just no systematic or even, you know, programmatic way of training young people or anyone.
Every city, major city, has an assessment program like the Minnesota Music Teachers Association, and all of them are different, they're kind of reinventing the wheel in all of the cities. The levels are different, the technique is different, everyone's kind of off in their own little world.
So the only option, I think, is to create a very connected set of partnerships among music teachers so that you come together as a cohesive unit to do something for musical literacy, because it's pretty much, this is it, all of you here. The partnership really is with all of you. That's the most important partnership, because without that, none of this really goes anywhere.
The program benefits schools because it provides a connection really across the country. One of the benefits of the program is that it's a national standard, and so it takes us out of our local and even our region and brings us to understand the benefits of music study and piano study across the entire nation.
And this program provides a framework, a guideline for teachers, a chance for children to benchmark effectively across the country to a standard that is, I think, phenomenally well thought through.
It enables students to progress naturally in logical steps from the absolute beginnings of the study of musical instrument all the way to the most advanced levels.
There's such a great need to assess arts education in general, and it's one of the most controversial things you can ever think about assessing, and somehow the development program has come up with a way to do this that is very respectful. They've figured out how to standardize it without compromising artistic creativity.
This program has it all, and it, you know, has a history of 100 years plus of success.
I thought that this program was really important to sort of spread throughout the United States. I know that it's been a sort of tradition in Canada. I thought it was really a wonderful thing for us in the U.S., and I wanted to be a representative of that and to support it and help it progress.
I mean, I knew right away I wanted to be a part.
I think it gives teachers a way of thinking about comprehensive learning that is perhaps new and also perhaps invigorating, because I think we all strive to do that, but we don't always necessarily feel that we have the tools to be able to do so, and the program really gives us the tools to be able to do that.
As a professional, you learn how to set your own goals and you look for new challenges, but for students, the levels and survivability to see that there's more coming up is a great challenge and great motivation.
It's a chance for children to learn to handle themselves in pressured situations, in situations where there are distinct demands placed on them, and they take home just a tremendous sense of accomplishment.
And it's super important to my kids, even though they don't realize it.